No, do not fall. No. Well, hello, my lovely nestlings, and welcome to my channel. If you are new, welcome. My name is Nikki. I'm 44 from the Netherlands, hence the accent. And today I'm doing another chatty get ready with me using some new goodies and something that is older. But I'm actually curious, like me, also like me, curious to know if I still like it. Sometimes I have that about myself as well. I already put on primer. I used the Milk Hydro Grip because I don't know. I did show it in a video. I don't remember which one. But basically, I kind of push it in my brows and then push my brows up as well. But I thought, let's kind of save time and do the brows already. So that is why I already primed the face. Yes, I'm wearing a sweater because it's actually autumn-like weather here today. I think the maximum temperature of today will be 17 degrees Celsius. So yeah. It's a very big leap from last week where it was, where I'm filming, I think about 35 degrees Celsius. So yeah, I have some new goodies also to try out. I think I already said that, but what happened? If you follow me on Instagram, you may have seen my, what was it, story? Yes, that I got presents, and I love presents. So yeah. I got these. I'm sorry for the shine. They are very, very shiny. But one of you, and I still don't know if you want me to say your name, so I'm not going to. It basically started with a red eyeshadow. And she said, or you said, I had to scroll back quite a bit for that conversation, by the way, about her favorite red shimmer and that the next time she would order one from me as well. Now, her favorite red shimmer is from the Vina. It's the shade Salvatore. And yeah, because she also knows that I don't grab for single shades, but more for palettes, she sent me a palette. She also sent me the Sassy Siennas from Dose of Colors. So yeah, I really wanted to use the red. However, I'm so feeling this shade, which is the shade called Messier. But this was actually, oh no, do not fall, no! Thankfully it fell on my table and nothing happened. This, Jeffree Star has something similar in his Alien palette and it's actually one of my favorite shades. However, yeah, Jeffree Star is not one of my favorite people. So, I'm so happy that I have a replacement. I don't even know if you can see the shift. It's teal with, oh lord, it's teal with, it looks brown, but there is brown, but also purple, and I think a bit of, I need this on my eyeball today. So yeah, I will use the red one, but not today. So sorry, I really need to use that one. But what did I do? Because I tried to pull them out again out of the palette, but I couldn't. So I actually, I don't know if you can see, I made stickers with the names. Stop it with the shine. I made stickers with the names and those are there. So I can easily see the shades I'm going to use. So I'm going to use these Divina shades today. And I'm also going to use the Sassy Siennas. I kind of did feel them. So I'm very curious and I just love the tiny little brush that it came with. But yeah, if you don't know what the Sassy Siennas looks like, it's this. This is actually their old packaging because they upgraded their packaging. And I'm very curious how this formula is. Now, I have already swatched the Divina palette. Oh, yeah, that's on my Instagram. Yes. If I feel like it, I will put a picture in. But yeah, so I have that. But I also have some stuff from Kiko Milano. From, no! Yes, it's one of those days. I have a bronzer and I have a blush. So I got from their Unexpected Paradise. It's huge, but oh, it smells like coconut. This is what it, so this is the outer box. This is what it comes in. This bronzer was a little bit more pricier, but I think I got 25% off or something like that. It was around 20 euros. So it is pricier. However, you do get 20 grams. But look how this looks. How cool is this? And I'm so glad that they did not put the, what is it, floral scent in here. I detest floral scent. Yeah, I love flowers, but oh, this smells like coconut. So this is the shade that I got. I think it was the lightest one. They had three bronzers. They had two kind of shimmery bronzers and then one not. And this is the color Warm Honey. So I have that. I also got a blush in Aspirational Mauve. And it's the same this feels so luxurious. This is what the component looks like. It's plastic, but still. And here, oh, it is a very, very pretty color. So I have those, yes. So those are new. So I have a new bronzer and I have a new blush. Let me put it there. I also have some new eye pencils from Kiko. From Kiko Milano. Let me get them out. So I really love these. And I got the color 03, which is... I don't know. It's a bronze. Because I have a bronze from L'Oreal. From the Infallible. But I wanted a replacement because L'Oreal isn't cruelty free. I also got this one, which is in the color 10. Which is... let me swatch them. Feels so creamy. So that's 10. Then this is the bronze. And then I also got from one... It's another line. But this is a light blue. Can I... Thank you. And this is a twist up. So here are the colors that I got. And I already had two colors from their other... from this line. I had a green one and a very deep teal. So yeah, I don't know actually if I will use one of these today. I don't know, but those are new as well. I feel low in energy, but that's maybe because I ran 5 kilometers this morning. It has been a while since I ran that far. I also got a new falsy style from Primark in the style Paris. Because the Londons and the Dubais are currently sold out every time I go to Primark. So I couldn't stock up on that. I still have some, but yeah. So yeah. I even have a new sponge. It's from Real Techniques and I had something like this, but it's a new one. I just opened the packaging. I have some new setting sprays. Oh yeah, I also have a new pair of falsies from Catrice. These are the Lash Couture Classicista, I don't know, volume lashes. And I already have the Insta volume, but it's I've already been filming for over 8 minutes and I have not put anything on the face, so yeah. Let's start with the foundation, because this is a foundation that I loved. What was it? 2 years ago, I think. It's one from Primark and it is the Double Coverage Matte Foundation. It is a very, very nice alternative for the Estée Lauder Double Wear. I did a side-by-side comparison video. I will link it down below and underneath the cards. And I'm actually curious to see if I still like it. Now, Estée Lauder one kind of settles into the lines. This one did as well. But still, I am curious to see how it will perform. So let's just go and grab my sheet and try it. Now, I have some more new stuff because this morning, actually, my Lethal Cosmetics After Dark palette came in. So let me show you what this looks like. Oh, and it's so... Do not dig your finger in. The palette was nice. So here is what she looks like. And I was debating. I really want to play with this. But I thought, no. I'm going to play with the Vina and Dose of Colors first. And also, I also need to kind of film with this one. Which is the Pride palette from Makeup Revolution. Which also looks very, very pretty. This is what it looks like. It's a rainbow palette, but still, it does look pretty. So I need to film with this one as well. So yeah, busy. Okay, let's first put some foundation on the face. Let's do that first. It has been a while since I have used this one. And if you want to try the Estée Lauder Double Wear, or if you, I don't know that you like it but don't want to pay it anymore, if you have a Primark, check out this one. Because it is such a good alternative. They are so close together, but this one retails for me at least for 5 euros or 5.50, and the Estée Lauder Double Wear for 50. So yeah, it's about 10 times more expensive. And I really loved the color and loved the finish. The only difference was though that it kind of settled into my lines. But wear time and all that, there was almost no difference. The Estée Lauder looked a little bit prettier. But the difference was so slight that for me it does not warrant the price. Also, Estée Lauder is not cruelty free. And Primark is. And I have the color beige. And it's... Yeah, it is a nice color for me. I know I can build it up. Let's build it up in certain areas because I don't feel like using concealer today. You know, if I have a full coverage foundation or a... You know, why should I use concealer as well? I don't see the point. I just, unless I want to brighten up or darken up parts, I usually don't bother. I do have pretty dark circles though. But it did settle into my lines a bit. There is that. But yeah, we will see how it fares throughout the day today. I don't know. And if I don't like it, I can always take it off. Do I want contour? No, not really. Not today. Let me just... Oh yeah, my bronzer. I have one bronzing stick, one cream bronzer. But the component fell apart, so I kind of put sticky tape on it. So the component is now fixed. That's what you get when you love a product so much that you kind of wreck it, you know? So let me put on some cream bronzer. Now, as I'm filming this, today is Monday, the 6th of July. Yesterday, my beauty community tag video went online. And it was... the response from you guys was so, so nice. I'm so glad that that I gave you alternatives. And that we, because it was a collab video, could show you how beautiful the beauty community is. Now, even though Mr. Dawson, you know, he's an idiot for saying it. But what he did do is bring the beauty community together even more. So yeah, there is that. Everything has a purpose. And yeah, maybe that was his purpose. I don't know. But anyway... the best thing about this is that my friend Anki and my friend Debbie, I will link both channels down below because now I can link them very easily because they both hit 1k yesterday and it was just so amazing. I know especially Debbie thought that she would never reach it. And it's just so cool to see that they both finally did. It's just amazing. So yeah, I hope that you will enjoy their channels as much as I do. It was just the best. A cream blush. Let me... Where did I put those? Oh yeah, I kind of rearranged stuff again. I kind of... What do I want for blush? Let me use the watermelon from MUA. Shake it up a bit. And how do I use it? It's kind of a... This is more of a skin tint. And I kind of do that on the back of my hand. And then I kind of stipple a bit with a brush. And then gently... Because this one is pretty pigmented for me also. Even though I am a bit more tan at the moment. I will also link another video down below from Michelle from Lab Muffin Beauty Science. She is a chemist and a skincare enthusiast. And she is debunking skincare myth after skincare myth. She recently did a video about sunscreen and if it is necessary to wear sunscreen indoors. And I learned so much from her. You know, I always thought, because people said so, that the UVA, that kind of is for the aging part, was the same strength all year round. It's not. My desk where I edit, where my computer is in front of the window. I always thought that I needed to wear my SPF if I was in front of the window. And I kind of do, but it all kind of depends. So go watch that video. I learned a lot. Am I still wearing sunscreen? Yes, of course I am. Especially in summer. But now I know that it is okay to use an SPF of 30 in winter. And then, you know, if I'm just indoors all day or maybe just the only time I'm going to go outside is because I need to walk the dog. It's SPF 30 is basically also good, you know. Go watch that video. You will learn a lot, I promise. So yeah, there is that. Okay, that was the blush and it is so pretty. Oh, I love these blushes so, so much. Powder. Yes. Shall I get Fenty? Sure. Let's get the Fenty. So I have the Fenty one in butter. I really like it. It does crease underneath my eyes, but not as bad as I remember. it does really settle into line. So I'm going to set there with the sponge. I'm not going to bake. I'm just going to press the powder in so it sets it. Does that help? I don't know if this helps though. No, not really. So yeah, unfortunately there's that. But as I said, the Estee Lauder did that as well. I'm not using a lot of powder. It may look like it, but I'm not. Oh, I forgot my... No, I forgot my freckles. Oh. Now, I know I can put my freckles on top of my foundation, so there's that. And I don't know if you can see it, but I have natural freckles and such. So I kind of think it is cute if I can bring them back. So let me get my freckle pen from Lime Crime and just bring back some of the freckle stuff. Usually I do this underneath my powder, but yeah, I forgot today. And I basically just find the real ones as well. And here, this spot is actually a red. It's post-inflammatory hyperpigmentation. It's always a mouthful. But I kind of make this in one into a thingy too. So, something like that. And you can let it kind of cure if you want to. You can tap over it and tap them out a bit more. Sometimes I kind of do them both. But yeah, today, let's just let them have their moment. Okay, I also need an eye base. What's the eye base I want to use? Oh, I can wear the one, I can use the one from Revolution. I do really like this one, the clear one. But I don't like it if it is too warm outside. Just saying. I think I mentioned this. I don't remember where I mentioned it, but I know I mentioned it. I think that if you have oily lids, you will not like this. If your preferred, if you really, really like, for instance, the MAC Paint Pot, you know, the dryer formula, I don't know if you will like this because this is more emollient. And when it's very, very warm outside, this is too... almost too wet, too hydrating for me. Okay, let's get a brush. Let's get the bronzer from Kiko. Ooh. I pick up quite a lot. I don't really know if you will see it, but... that's okay, because I'm not really into a very, very bronzed face anyway. My chair is making noise. Pretty. It has a sheen but not a shimmer, and I like a sheen. I'm not really into shimmery bronzers, not anymore. So let's also try the blush. Let's clean the brush. Let's go in a little bit slow because it picks up quite a lot. This is a matte blush. It's pretty. I think this is a color that if you that can actually fit a lot of skin tones. I was kind of worried about that because, yeah, the range for Kiko's powder products, or at least, you know, three shades of bronzer. And then I think they had, I don't know, also kind of three shades of blush in that range. However, I do think that you can, that a lot of skin tones can use this. Not the deepest ones, because I don't think that you will see the color then. But yeah, I think it's pretty. Okay. Oh. Okay, okay. Let's kind of grab a brown from the sassy Sienna palette. Oh, that
it is so cute.
Let's try the tiny side for underneath the eye. Let's start there for funsies. Okay, then let's kind of blend it out with the other side. Okay, so I can already tell that this brush is not really my favorite. It's a little bit too scratchy for my liking. It's one from Sigma. I need to get me another one of these. So basically the idea is, because I really like this color. Oh, did I show you the color that I'm using? I don't think so. I'm using the darkest brown of the Sienna. And I don't know if that is Stay Sassy or Oh So Sassy. I don't know, but it's the darkest one. That's the one I'm using. And I'm just going to pull it. I'm just going to do a one matte crease. And then let that shimmer shine. Pun not intended. Well, kinda. But that does not matter. What else did I want to talk about? Oh yeah, I needed to learn. I have been using, since I have started my channel, DaVinci Resolve to edit my videos. I really like that program. But I don't know why. It is kind of, every time I want to zoom in, or I want to have that pan zoom, you know, it kind of quits on me. So I was like, that's really, really annoying. So I found another software that I'm using now. I'm currently using Filmora 9. So yeah, I had to learn to work with a new software in a day. So yeah, that was the thingy as well. But I do like it. What I like about it as well is the different transitions and title styles that are in there. So yeah, I like it. The only downside is, though, I used to work a lot with markers, colored markers. And there are colored markers here. But the colored markers don't show up underneath the picture. Now, if you have edited a video on your computer, you know that you have your timeline and then you have your screen where you can kind of see what you are doing. In DaVinci Resolve, I could see there as well where I had placed my markers. And I cannot see that in Filmora, which is kind of... That is kind of annoying. So I cannot jump from one marker to another because I cannot see them underneath on that larger timeline thingy-majingy. So that is, I hope they can kind of fix that. But yeah, I'm not sure if they will. I'm going to bring it up a little bit higher here because I like that shape a bit more. Okay, let's get another brush. Let's sketch you. This is a clean, soft, fluffy brush. This shadow blends very, very nicely, though. I think it's shimmer time. Now, I don't really think that the Divina shadows need a glitter primer. I am going to use one, though, because we are having a bit of a shitty weather day today. And I want them to stick. At least if I can find my... glitter primer. Where did I leave it? Oh, there, where... With the... Oh, there I am. With the rest of the eye primer. So I have here my NYX glitter primer. Let me get a flat brush. And I'm just going to do this. Just a tiny bit on the brush. I don't even know if you can see it. Yes. That's going to go on my eye. And then that shimmery goodness is going to go on top. I'm just going to pat. I don't really need a clean, cut, creasy thingy. Whatever. Okay, let's do the other eye too. Yes, let's go into the color called Messier. D. D? Did I say D? Yes, that's Dutch for that one. D, that one. Yes. Oh. Maybe I can use the red on the outside. Of course I can. Oh, but this is so cool. This is not, it's a lot of the I do have a little bit of fallout though. A lot of the time shades like this have a brown base. This one is a red. It's a red, reddish, purple, pink, whatever majingy, that color, and then with teal. Okay, I'm going to go into the color Salvatore, which is that gorgeous red. Oh, I pick up quite a lot. And I'm just going to put that on the outside corner. Okay, one side is a little bit of the red. The other side of the brush is a little bit of that other color. Wow, that was a weird word. I'm just going to pull them on top of each other. I want that red a little bit more in. Because I think it's pretty if it kind of goes in a diagonal line. Oh lord, this is so cool. What do I want? Ooh, that may be fun. Let me get my red eye pencil, I think. Or is that... yes, let me get my red eye pencil. Technically it's a lip pencil, don't come for me. Okay, what I'm going to do then is I'm actually going to grab the shade Salvatore a little. And for the outside of my eye. Yes, then I'm cleaning the brush and I'm going to go into the color Messier. I'm going to spray that one because I have a little bit more trouble picking it up with a brush. Maybe I need to put down a glitter primer first. Wait. So I have cleaned my brush. I'm grabbing my glitter primer and I'm going to press it on my eye so that I can put that other shimmer on top. Okay, then I'm going to go to the color Messier. Okay, let me see which one I want for inner corner. This one, I think, yeah. So that is the color Nerds, which I'm going to use in my inner corner. And I'm going to pull it around a little. Oh, this is so pretty. And this one that I'm using now kind of reminds me of the flakes that I have from 5050. They are kind of the same color, almost. Yes, I really, really like this. I do have quite a bit of fallout, but I actually don't care. Let's see if I can kind of get rid of it. No, no, that means that I will have a shimmery there. I don't care at all. Stay close, please. Okay. No. Shh. I love this a lot. I do want falsies, but I don't really know what falsies. I don't want to break, make... do a new pair. What do I have here? How about my Londons then? Let's see. Yep. I'm making weird noises, but that's not really new for me. Yeah, I think I'm going to plop these on. So let me put on my falsies real quick. Oh, the glue is in front of me. Wow. If you want to know a more in-depth tutorial, I have one. It's not rocket science. Basically, I'm painting the glue on my eyelid. Where I would put the eyeliner. Today, I'm not going to wear eyeliner. And that is why I'm also not using mascara before I put on the falsies. so I can better see where I place them. Okay, falsies are on. Let me get some mascara. And the mascara I use is a tube mascara. This one from Essence, it does not really matter. But the nice thing about this is it will not mess up my falsies. Usually if I put a normal mascara over here, it will kind of mess up my falsies. And the tube mascara doesn't. The only thing I do want to do is a little bit of... here... Basically, I'm kind of tightlining a little bit with this one, which is a waterproof one, and I kind of go like I kind of make hair-like strokes. And this is one from Catrice. It's their brush ink tattoo liner, I believe it is called, in waterproof. So that's the eye look. And for lips, where's the color Hustle? Here it is. I think I want this one. Yeah, and this one is a lip cream from Makeup Revolution in the color Hustle. I really like this one. It's actually my favorite color from them. And then this is the finished look, guys. So let me kind of go over... Let's start with the foundation. How is that looking? Yeah, it's... It's looking nice, but it is just the same thing with the Estée Lauder Double Wear that this... It does not settle into the lines. It kind of skips them. So, yeah, that is what happens with this foundation. But it also happens with the Double Wear for me. So there is that. But I do still really like it. So I can kind of, you know, I will put it somewhere that I can use it up. And then that's probably going to be it. The sponge from Real Techniques. I love this sponge a lot. It's nice and soft. I really, really like these sponges. Let's go to the blush and the bronzer first. I like them a lot. I think they are very, very pretty. I love the scent. I'm not really one for scented makeup, but I'm very, very happy that they did not put in a floral scent here, because the floral scent that I had in the perfecting powder almost made me throw up when I first opened it. I do love a coconut scent though. So yeah, I think that the components are gorgeous. You get so much in this bronzer. I don't know if I will finish this. This is so much, but it is very pretty. It has a sheen. I think it's... I did not swatch it, did I? So let me... Yeah, I don't know if you... Let me put it here. So it is a light bronzer. But I think this will be my favorite, because I really like the color of it. So that is very, very nice. So I cannot wait to try this one out more. And the blush color, yeah, it's also very, very pretty. That mauve, Unexpected Paradise blush in Aspirational Mauve. I think the color is gorgeous. The formula is very nice. It blends nicely. It's not patchy. I did pick up quite a bit, but I could easily sheer it out with the brush. Yeah, I understand why people rave about this these products from Kiko. I hadn't tried... I only tried their setting powder, their eye pencils, and then their perfecting powder. And I'm very happy that I bought these two as well. Yeah, the pencils I didn't use. I know the formula though. And I really like the colors. But yeah, obviously I did not use them today. So let's then go to the eyeshadow palette. Oh, first off, this blended very, very nicely. When I felt the shades, I was like, ooh, they feel really nice and really, I don't know, they feel a certain way. And I was like, I don't think that I will have problems blending this. Now, I only use this shade because it was the darkest one. It was also a little bit of a cooler toned one. I just wanted to use this shade today and it blended without any effort. Without any effort at all. It is not patchy. Yeah, I cannot wait to use the other shades too. And then the Divina. Yeah, the shades that I used are these three I used. Oh Lord, they're so pretty. So the red one is called Salvatore, and then the one that I have in the beginning of my lid is called Messier, and then the other one that I have in the inner corner is called Nerds. And the other shades I have, this golden one is called Celesta, then this one is called Gumballs, and then this one is called And Your Little Dog Too. Those are the shades that I have. Oh, and they are so pretty. I love the fact that this one does not have that brown base or brown shift, but it has a pinky purple one. And I think it complements the red very, very nicely. And the red is also a little bit more of a, I don't know, it also has a hint of pink in it. Oh, gorgeous. Thank you so, so freaking much for sending this to me. It's just, you almost made me cry. And I'm not a pretty crier at all. I'm a very, very ugly crier. But thank you so, so much. I love it. I love it. I love it. And I am very happy that I tried... I know I just tried one shade. But now that I know that I will like the formula of the Dose of Colors, I can, I don't know, you know, try some of their other smaller palettes. Because I did have my eye on them, but they are pricier and I didn't know if I would like the formula. Now I do know that I will probably like that formula as well. So I can kind of look to their other colors a little bit. That purpley one kind of has my name on it. Just saying. So yeah, and the rest was not really new. The rest I had already used. I don't know if I was very chatty today. Sometimes that happens. But yeah, this was it. Let me know down below if you have any of the goodies that I used today. And... that is it. I am going to wish you a... no. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them down in the comment section below. Thank you so, so much for watching. I'm going to wish you a fantastic day, a fabulous evening. Stay safe, stay healthy, try to stay sane. And I will see you very soon in my next one. Bye, guys.